I mean, I'm not able to work as much because now I'm full-time dad. I have to get her to school. I got to get her picked up. I mean, there's people that are willing to help, but it's not something I can have a pattern with. The pattern now is get her up, get her ready for school. I mean, I used to be able to start work at 6 o'clock in the morning or something like that. Now, you know, I can't get there until 8:30. And so a lot of things have changed, and it's, you know, and I'm trying to make these adjustments, and there's things like big changes that are going to have to happen. And I'm going, you know, look at this empty seat or something and go, so what do you think? Please tell me something, do something to make me realize or, you know, understand if I'm going in the right direction, am I making the right choice, you know, because I did, you know, I missed the opinion. Jenny and I, since this whole thing happened, I mean, even since our whole marriage has been, you know, dodging catastrophe after catastrophe. I mean, I had a minor stroke when we first met, and then she got cancer, and then, you know, I was my dad's caregiver through his cancer, and then my mom, she passed on in January, and then Jenny went right after that, so... Why don't you talk about what Mommy did for you, what you and Mommy did together.
Okay.
You guys did a lot of things together,
so. My Mommy played outside with me, and my mom was right there. She played games with me. She was in my heart.
This is not a common situation for hardly anybody to lose a spouse, and especially the more nurturing. I mean, I feel like I'm nurturing, but nobody's as nurturing as your mother. You know, it's like I said, every day you learn, and it's only been 4 months. It feels like it's been a year already, and it's only been 4 months.